Hey guys, Blake Paulson here from Unleashed Drum Studio in North Hollywood, California. As always, I hope that you are doing great. What do you do when your rack tom rings too long? Before you grab a bunch of gaff tape or gels, let's first look at your drum's mounting system to control the sustain. Today's video is on the subject of rack tom sustain and why I prefer to use a snare stand to mount my rack tom. If you've played in a wide variety of different rooms, studios, and stages, you've probably noticed that the amount your toms ring is different for each space that you're drumming in. This is why we need good sounding methods for controlling our sustain. For today's example, I'll be using a 9x13 inch A&F Drumco Black Club Mahogany Tom. As you can see, I have my rack tom mounted on a snare stand, in this case, a DW6000 series stand. It's a thin, lightweight stand with an offset basket and a flat base. The other common ways to mount a rack tom are on an L-type pole that goes into holes drilled in both the tom and the bass drum, or on a suspension mount like a RIMS brand mount, which suspends the tom with rubber grommets. Suspension mounts can be hung from a pole in the bass drum, a standalone tripod stand, or a full-blown rack system. I prefer a snare stand for several reasons. The first reason is that a snare stand is easier to position. Compared with mounting a tom on a pole through your bass drum, a snare stand is more flexible to get the exact position that you want. On top of that, I prefer to play virgin bass drums and virgin toms that don't have holes cut into them. When you think about it, cutting holes into the drum is essentially damaging them, and to a degree, it's damaging their sonic characteristics. The second reason I prefer a snare stand is because a snare stand is more solid to play. Suspension mounts can allow the tom to bounce up and down while you're playing. Snare stands keep the drum exactly where you put it without any extra movement. The third reason I prefer a snare stand is because a snare stand sounds better. Suspension mounts have been popular since the 90s as a way to maximize a drum's resonance and sustain. They work really well. However, they actually work too well, helping a tom ring for an extremely long time. So long a time that it can actually lead to the overuse of tape, gel, or other muffling devices, which can really kill a drum's sound and playability. A snare stand sounds better because it's an adjustable way to control sustain that doesn't allow for excessive ring. It actually helps you minimize the amount of muffling that you might otherwise add to the drum head. A snare stand works by directly connecting or grounding your drum to the floor. After you strike the drum, this connection to the floor helps dissipate excess energy from the vibrating heads. At first thought, this may seem like a bad idea. However, today's drums are made so well and resonate so freely that a bit of grounding can be very useful. The cool thing about a snare stand is that the amount of grounding is adjustable. Your adjustment tool is the snare basket itself. With the drum sitting loosely in the basket, you get the least amount of grounding. With the drum being tightly held by the basket, you get the most amount of grounding. It's important to note that snare stands are not created equal. I specifically use the DW6000 stand because one, it's professional grade, and it's made with thin, lightweight metal. A lightweight stand pulls less sustain out of the drum than a heavier stand. Two, it's an adjustable size basket. This allows you to control how tightly the drum is being gripped versus one size fits all baskets. Three, its basket is offset, which pulls less sustain out of the drum than a center mounted basket. And four, the legs of the stand are flat. This can actually pull more sustain from a drum, but with its rubber feet and an overall light weight, its flat legs don't cause overgrounding. Let's take a listen to the different levels of sustain we can get by adjusting the basket from loose to tight. Then we'll continue to dampen further by adding some snare weight M80s, which are my favorite dampeners. As you can hear, there's a range of sustain options possible from this system, and all are easily adjusted in seconds so that you can adapt to each venue that you play. Keep in mind that my studio is quite dead. Listening to these samples is only representative of their sound in this room. For example, the Tight Basket plus two M80s may sound really dead in my room, but in a bright venue with lots of brick or concrete, it may be the perfect choice. These are the reasons I prefer to mount my rack tom on a snare stand. I would love to hear your thoughts and questions in the comments below. As always, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please hit thumbs up, subscribe, and share. Take care, guys.